Dressing means the material applied, or the application itself of material, to a wound for protection, healing, absorbance. The procedure includes cleaning, disinfection and protection of the wound, which has a significant impact on the speed of healing, the function of the repaired skin and cosmetic appearance of the resulting scar. Dressing wounds is a process that may seem intimidating at first. Still, it can become a comfortable and straightforward process with enough practice. Every wound dressing has pros and cons when it comes to medical treatments. Thus, most professionals recommend trying different ones to see which works best. There are countless brands, styles, and shapes of bandages on the market today. All these choices make it hard to work out what's best for different patients. Wound dressings should provide the most optimum conditions for wound healing while protecting the wound from infection with microorganisms and further trauma. Choosing the correct dressing will lessen the time of healing, provide cost-effective care, and improve the patient's quality of life. Assessment of the patient with an open wound involves a holistic approach, and there are many facets of the evaluation that go beyond purely the physical makeup of the wound, e.g., the appropriate diagnosis of the wound etiology, patient comorbidities, nutrition, and tissue oxygenation. Open wounds are dynamic and are continuously changing, therefore, dressing selection for optimal healing must also change. It is rare that a singular treatment plan for any given wound will remain the same throughout the healing process. Decision-making relative to treatment is based on a thorough assessment of the patient and the wound at regular intervals so that timely changes in the care plan can be made. Characteristics of the ideal wound dressing. There is no one-size-fits-all for dressing selection for open wounds. There are literally thousands of dressings available considering the various categories, shapes, and sizes. Although the form, i.e., the ingredients, of the dressing is important, the function, or how it will optimize the wound environment, is more essential in decision-making. Optimal dressing selection depends on a thorough assessment of the wound, especially for the primary dressing that will interact with the wound bed to facilitate healing, as well as assessment of the patient. Activity levels and patient goals are important for selection of the secondary dressings and interventions such as negative pressure wound therapy that may affect activities of daily living and work demands. The ideal wound dressing should be capable of maintaining a high humidity at the wound site while removing excess exudate. Free of particles and toxic wound contaminants. Non-toxic and non-allergenic. Capable of protecting the wound from further trauma. Can be removed without causing trauma to the wound. Impermeable to bacteria. Thermally insulating. Will allow gaseous exchange. Comfortable and conformable. Require infrequent changes. Cost-effective. Long shelf life. Modern dressing technology is based on the principle of creating and maintaining a moist wound environment. The concept of using a wet-to-moist dressing to avoid wound trauma may still cause injury. Nevertheless, it may become a wet-to-dry dressing in practice. Normal saline is isotonic. As water evaporates from the saline dressing, it becomes hypertonic and fluid from the wound tissues is drawn into the dressing in an attempt to re-establish isotonicity. However, wound fluid is not merely water, it contains blood and proteins that may begin to form an impermeable layer on the dressing surface. At this point, fluid from the wound is unable to replace the fluid lost from the dressing by evaporation and the dressing dries out completely. Additionally, cooling of the tissues at dressing changes may impede healing. Evaporation of water from a surface results in a reduction of temperature at that surface. Reduction in tissue temperature has multiple physiologic effects, including local reflex vasoconstriction and hypoxia, impairment of leukocyte mobility and phagocytic efficiency, and increased affinity of hemoglobin for oxygen. All of which not only impede healing but increase susceptibility to infection. Gauze dressings present no physical barrier to the entry of exogenous bacteria. An in vitro study showed that bacteria were capable of penetrating up to 64 layers of dry gauze, and moistened gauze provides even less of a barrier to bacterial penetration, again increasing the risk of infection. In a literature review of 3,047 wounds, the overall infection rate for wounds dressed with moisture-retentive dressings was 2.6%, whereas the infection rate for gauze-dressed wounds was 7.1%. Wound dressing categories. A myriad of dressing materials are available to meet the ever-changing needs of the open wound. Film dressings. Film dressings are polyurethane self-adhering membranes that are moisture vapor permeable, meaning that they allow gaseous exchange from the wound bed. Film dressings are thin and flexible and thus allow visualization of the wound and surrounding skin. They are frequently used on intact skin for protection from friction and moisture and to reduce shear. Standard film dressings have no ability to absorb exudate, thus are not indicated for draining wounds. There is, however, a film dressing that incorporates an acrylic polymer pad so that exudate transfers through perforations and into the absorbent pad and away from the wound surface. Advantages of film dressings. Allows visualization of the wound bed and the wound exudate. Protects skin in high trauma areas, heals, sacrum. Is impermeable to fluids and bacteria. Conforms to body contours. Facilitates autolytic debridement. Serves as a secondary dressing. Is cost-effective. Disadvantages/considerations with film dressings. May tear fragile skin upon removal. Does not absorb exudate. May not adhere well to dry, flaky skin. May macerate skin if fluid collects underneath the film. May exacerbate fungal growth if present on skin. Tends to roll at the edges in areas of high friction. Hydrogels and hydrogel dressings. Hydrogels are water or glycerin-based products that are either amorphous, defined as dispensed from a tube or impregnated into gauze dressings, or cross-linked polymers formed into three-dimensional sheets. Hydrogels are moisture-donating products that enable the most rapid hydration of a wound surface. The peri-wound skin of a wound treated with hydrogels may need protection with a moisture barrier film or ointment to prevent overhydration or maceration. Hydrogels are used for dry wounds and are contraindicated for wounds that have visible exudate. They have a cooling effect that helps to relieve pain and reduce inflammation. Advantages of hydrogels. Hydrate dry wound beds. Facilitate autolytic debridement when used under an occlusive dressing. Rinse or clean easily from the wound surface. Conform to the shape of the wound and fills all spaces. Soothe hot wounds and reduce pain. Serve as a delivery system for other agents such as silver, collagen, growth factors, or lidocaine. Are available in saturated gauze pads for flat wounds. Disadvantages/considerations with hydrogels. Macerate the peri-wound skin if wound becomes too wet. Do not absorb drainage. Dry out if not covered adequately. Require a secondary dressing. Usually require daily dressing changes. Hydrocolloid dressings. Hydrocolloids are wafer-type dressings composed of three layers. An inner slightly adhesive layer, a middle absorbent layer, and an outer semi-occlusive layer. The middle absorbent layer contains combinations of gelatin, pectin, and carboxymethyl cellulose with hydrophilic particles, which interact with wound fluid to form a gel mass over the wound bed and thereby maintain a moist environment, support autolytic debridement, and prevent trauma upon removal. The resulting gel is reported to be acidic, therefore, not conducive to bacterial growth. However, caution is advised in suspected or known wound infection, as the resulting gel dressing becomes occlusive in nature and may support bacterial proliferation. The outer layer of the hydrocolloid dressings is either film or foam-based and does not allow contamination from the outside environment to reach the wound, nor does it allow exudate to strike through from beneath the dressing. Advantages of hydrocolloids: maintain moist wound environment, keep bacteria, moisture, and contamination from incontinence out of the wound bed, absorb minimal to moderate exudate, facilitate autolytic debridement, provide thermal insulation to maintain optimal wound temperature, stay in place up to 7 days, are effective under compression wraps, are self-adhering, do not need a secondary dressing if the borders are adhesive, conform to the surface of a flat wound, come in various shapes, sizes, and thicknesses. Disadvantages/considerations with hydrocolloids: prevent visualization of the wound bed, do not absorb heavy exudate, are not recommended for covering exposed structures, tendon, bone, are contraindicated for infection, are difficult to remove from fragile skin, may leak, leaving sticky residue on the skin, require a different primary dressing to fill spaces such as fissures or undermining, paste, powders, etc. Hydrocolloids are effective in protecting peri-wound skin when other dressings are likely to cause maceration, for example, in conjunction with NPWT systems or when using moist dressings to fill large cavity wounds. Foam dressings.